Hi there. I recently had a chance this week to visit two of Kimberley's most famous coffee houses, the Snowdrift and the Barking Gecko, to see what secrets there are to making their famous cinnamon buns. Betty at the Barking Gecko Cafe, and she's going to show us how to make cinnamon buns, aren't you?
Yes, I am. Okay, so let me take it out of here. Okay, I put a little bit of oil on the counter to spread it out so I can let this set for a few seconds. And then I cover it. And then we wait. Now we start to roll the dough out.
Wow, that looks like some hard work.
Yeah, I definitely work up your energy or your strength here. Putting some butter on the bottom. Whoops. It's a mucky job.
Yeah, people love that butter.
They do. Makes them juicy. Now we're putting the brown sugar on.
Yeah, that's the part that everybody likes.
Yeah, right to the edges. Now we sprinkle on some sugar, or cinnamon, sorry.
Wow, that looks great. It's a fancy little contraption you got there.
It is. Works perfect. Whoops, sorry. And then we start rolling. Roll it in nice and tight. Whoops. Probably as much bread dough in here in one cinnamon bun as it would be in a 2-pound loaf of bread, so they're quite big. Just cut this in half. And then I just put a little bit of butter in the bottom of a pan and sprinkle some brown sugar, and there. So then we'll put it on top of the oven for 5 or 10 minutes, let them rise, and then throw them in the oven. Okay, I've let them rise for about 5 minutes or so, and now I'm going to throw them into the oven. I put a pan under them because they get so juicy they could run over. And they're in the oven for 25 to 30 minutes. Then we take them out, throw some icing on, and they're done. So the cinnamon buns are ready. We're taking them out. Whoops, now. They turned out really big today for some reason. I don't know what's going on there, but huge.
Yeah, that looks great.
And we just take them out, dump them on a pan. Excuse me. Put some cream cheese icing on them. They're huge. They don't always turn out this big. This is exceptional.
Well, that looks great.
Probably 3 people could feast off one of these today. There you go. Voila, they're done. And then we just put them all
the- comes the best part, eating the buns. Now that's delicious. I'm here at the Snowdrift Cafe talking to Bridget, and she's going to show us how she makes cinnamon buns.
All right. So I've made my yummy secret spread. And now I'm going to portion out my dough. And I weigh it out. A little too big. Ah, just right. And some flour down so it doesn't stick. All right, now it's ready to roll out. There we go. I make it nice and long so you get lots of curls with sauce in them.
Wow, that sure looks great.
Oh yeah, that's our secret sauce. That what makes the Snowdrift cinnamon bun so famous. That and the whole wheat bread. It is whole wheat bread.
Whole wheat hearty bread.
Yep.
Nothing that tastes so good is so good for you, I guess.
Yeah. So you can have a sweet treat and it can actually be a little bit healthy. There we go. Nice and saucy. Then we roll it up. Oops. Make sure it's nice and even, and then I get 8 buns out of this.
Greasing up that pan?
Greasing up the pan so they don't stick. And into the pan. Hi. There we go. Then they need to rise for about half an hour, and then we cook them in the oven. Yum. Alrighty, now they've risen up, nice and puffy. Time to go in the oven. For 25 minutes. Whoa, they're ready. Piping hot. Then I just cut them apart. Flip them out onto the tray. Oh yeah, look at all that saucy goodness. Mmm.
And now the best part, I get to dig into this beautiful cinnamon bun. Mmm, that's some good eating. Well, the buns were incredible. I can't really say which one was better, but you're in for a treat if you go to either of these coffee houses.